Praise God, everybody. Ty Tribbett here.
This your girl, Demita.
Hi, this is Donnie McClurkin.
What's going on, y'all? This is your boy and your brother in the Lord Jesus Christ, the truth.
What's up, everybody? This is your boy, Fred Hammond.
What's up, family? It's your boy, Jay Moss, better known as Jess Jane.
Hey there, this is Erica from Mary Mary.
And I'm Tina.
What's up, people of God? It's your boy, T-Wise, and I'm chilling with my sister, your sister, Tamaya J on Never Miss a Beat.
Number 7.
What's up, family? It's your friend and brother, Dietrich Haddon, better known as E. Hattie, if you're following me on IG. Keep it locked right here with the Maya J, y'all, for the very best in gospel music, y'all, because we ain't going to miss the beat. You heard? Peace.
Number 6.
Lord, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Help us to love and see each other the way you love and see us. Come on.
My heart is always long for something more. I search the stars to knock on heaven's door. Creation groans for God to be revealed. Every wound we carry will be healed. My eyes on the sun. Lord, your will be done.
Thine is the kingdom.
Beautiful each color.
God created you to fly. Listen, don't you know that really you're too big for this planet? You were created for something bigger.
WREJ, Richmond, community involved, spiritually uplifting. Rejoice 101.3. We are Richmond.
Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network present a special edition of High School Football Friday Night. Tonight, live from Liberty University in Lynchburg, it's the 2022 Virginia High School League Class 4 State Championship as the unbeaten Dinwiddie Generals battle the unbeaten Cougars of Kettle Run High School. Tonight's game is being presented by Virginia Family Dentistry, featuring a team approach to dental care. With 16 Greater Richmond area locations, there's one near you. Go to vadentist.com for more. Now the pregame show, fueled by Massey Wooded West, fueling Virginia since 1923 at MasseyWoodedWest.com. Call 355-1721. Let's get to the action. Here's the voice of high school football Friday night, Rob Witham.
We greet you live from Williams Stadium on the campus of Liberty University in Lynchburg, Virginia. The sun is setting on this overcast second Saturday of December. And for one of the two teams getting ready for the Class 4 State Football Championship, this night will end in glory. For the other team, it will be the only defeat they have had in 2022 as the Cougars of Kettle Run High School from Fauquier County, Virginia, making their first ever state title appearance, coming in 14-0, taking on the Dinwiddie Generals, also 14-0, the survivors of Class 4 Region B, making their first state championship appearance since 2016, hoping for their first state title since they won it all 9 years ago. Hi, friends. Rob Witham live at Liberty University. This is the pregame show fueled by Massey Wood and West, fueling Virginia since 1923. Well, time's up. It's winter. We've been telling you all year long here on High School Football Friday Night about making sure you get that heating oil in before the winter sets in and the prices go up, and getting that HVAC checked or maybe repaired or replaced so that you've got plenty of heat for the winter ahead. Well, the winter is here. There won't be a day above 55 degrees for the foreseeable future, and nights are going to get in the 20s and 30s. So Massey Wood and West is who you need to call to get you set and ready to go. 804-355-1721 and MasseyWoodandWest.com. In 2023, they will be celebrating a century of fueling Virginia. Well, there were six state champions crowned in the RVA, crowned in 2022. And we are one of the three late games. Earlier here this afternoon was the Class 3 state championship, with Phoebus having no trouble with Heritage. And a congratulations back down in the 804 to Highland Springs. They get the job done in Class 5, complete their second 15-0 season with the state championship, the other one back in 2018, and winning their fifth state title since 2015. Winners today over Maury, 33-19, the final score. So the Springers are on their way back to the RVA with a state championship, and that's exactly what the Generals of Dinwiddie want to do. Dinwiddie was in, as you know, what we believe to be the toughest region in the state of Virginia in the VHSL, and that's Class 4 Region B. In that region, you had defending state champion Verina, who won the Class 4 championship on this field 52 weeks ago today. You had a King George team that had exploded onto the scene over the last 3 years, and they went unbeaten until falling in the regional final in overtime at Dinwiddie just 2 weeks ago. Not only did you have those two teams, you have perennial powers like Eastern View bouncing back, Hanover bouncing back. Patrick Henry had been in the regional championship two of the last three full seasons. So it was a gauntlet to get into the top eight. And for Dinwiddie, it was a situation of redemption, where in the shortened season of 2020, played back in the spring of 2021, you'll recall there were only four rounds of the playoffs, so there were only four teams that made it in the region. And Dinwiddie was not one of them. Dinwiddie missed the playoffs for the first time in ages. So they come back last year. They grabbed the number one seed in 4B. But in the region semifinals, Patrick Henry, with that senior-laden team, goes in and stuns Dinwiddie. And it ends up being PH and Verina in last year's region championship, won at the last second, of course, by the Blue Devils. So Dinwiddie looking for kind of redemption in 2022. They're able to get three huge non-district wins to start the season. They beat GW Danville 55-3. They beat Heritage of Lynchburg, who played in the Class 3 championship here earlier today, 49-7. They beat North Stafford 55-7. And by then, by week three, early September, all the eyes in 4B were shifting back over to Navy Nation. They got the job done, going undefeated in the regular season. Their biggest test was the last week of the season with fellow unbeaten Thomas Dale, and they hand them a 40-point beating, 63-23, to clinch that number one seed in 4B. Then it was handle your business in the region so you could get to the state. They beat Powhatan, no problem. They took Hanover out in the semifinal, no problem. The closest game of the year and the only one-possession victory of the year, that regional title game 2 weeks ago, 47-41 in overtime over a King George team we just had here on the air a few weeks ago. We know how good they were. A shutout win last week at home in the state semis, a 28-0 over Warwick, brings them here to Liberty University this afternoon. And of course, all eyes on quarterback Harry Dalton, who has done just remarkable work in this only his sophomore year. If you didn't know anything about Harry Dalton and you were looking at his stats and looking at his individual game performances, you would almost automatically assume he has to be a senior. No, he's class of 2025. He is going to be a force to be reckoned with for 2 years, even after this. Now, there's some senior leadership on this Dinwiddie team, no doubt. There's also a hunger in this team. The seniors were sophomores who missed the playoffs in the truncated year. The seniors were juniors last year who saw their heartbreak in the regional semifinals, the loss at home to Patrick Henry. They want redemption, and they want a second state championship for head coach Billy Mills. It's coming up in just a little bit. It'll be Dinwiddie Kettle Run, and we're checking the clock. Approximate kickoff time now going to be about 4:40 p.m., so about 18 minutes away here live from Liberty University. We're going to take our first time out here on the pregame show, fueled by Massey Wood and West, fueling Virginia since 1923. Calvin, rack up a three-minute timeout if you could, and when we come back, we'll talk a little bit about the journey of Kettle Run, their first ever trip to a state championship game, and get you ready for the Class 4 state final. It's the last game in RVA high school football in 2022. And what a way to cap off our 20th anniversary season of high school football Friday night with a very special Saturday edition here live from Lynchburg. Dinwiddie Kettle Run coming up in minutes. Back in 3 minutes, this is high school football Friday night state championship edition on Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West offers quality cleaning services for your HVAC units and can make sure your system's ready for the cold winter nights to come. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. The friendly staff at Massey Wood & West always looks out for your well-being and is working under all CDC guidelines. Need a new duct system? Massey Wood & West can handle that too. Plus, Massey Wood & West is proud to offer Rheem water heaters. So call 355-1721. Ask for Doug or Al. They'll be glad to help you get ready. 355-1721. Massey Wood & West. Online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit VirginiaDentist.com for more information.
See that cute little dog in the pet store? chances are it came from a puppy mill, a breeding facility that forces caged, neglected, and often sick dogs to churn out puppies to be sold for profit. Meanwhile, millions of wonderful, healthy pets end up in animal shelters. But with one simple choice, you can help, just by deciding to adopt instead of purchase your next pet. Not only are you saving a life, you're taking a stand against puppy mills. Visit bestfriends.org/puppymills to learn more.
Psst. Yeah, you. It's me, your heart. Listen to me. We've got to talk. High blood pressure is serious, and yours? Whoa. What happened to us? We used to be so much more active. But lately, you've been ignoring me. I know you think I'm just gonna keep ticking away forever, but you're wrong. You can do so much more to control your high blood pressure. Doing the minimum isn't doing enough. I'm under a lot of pressure and can quit whenever I want. Bet you didn't know that. But I like my job. Just treat me better. Check on me. Give me something green to nibble on every once in a while. And maybe we can do some exercise on occasion. Let's get to it. After all, we're in this together.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you. High blood pressure can lead to a stroke, heart attack, or death. Get your blood pressure to a healthy range before it's too late. Find out how at heart.org/bloodpressure. Check, change, control. A message from the American Heart Association, the American Stroke Association, and the Ad Council.
We're back with you here on the pregame show live from Williams Stadium on the campus of Liberty University in Lynchburg, Virginia. Absolutely gorgeous facility and a great place to put a capper on the 2022 high school football season. I can tell you, Kettle Run is from Fauquier County, so it's a few hours and it's not exactly an A to B drive from Northwest Virginia. They're east of Winchester. They're west of Arlington, Alexandria, up near the Dulles Airport area. But looking below me, they've traveled pretty well. But let me tell you something. Looking across the way at the Dinwiddie sideline, Navy Nation has traveled very, very well. Of course, you get on 460, in Dinwiddie, and you don't stop until you get to Williams Stadium. I mean, it's a straight shot. Route 460, Dinwiddie to Lynchburg, and a lot of people have made that trip here, this afternoon. Let's talk a little bit about Kettle Run, today's opponent, as soon as I, grab a quick drink of water to get whatever's there stuck in the throat out of the way. Kettle Run also coming in 14-0, mentioned that they are in the state championship for the first time in school history. Head coach Charlie Porterfield brings a very balanced attack to the game here today. You're going to have to keep, if you're the Dinwiddie defense, you're going to have speed on the ends. You're going to have toughness in the middle, and you got to make sure that nothing goes over the top in the secondary. Kettle Run, some of their games have been closer. It's not been a weekend, week out thrashing that Dinwiddie has been giving opponents all season long, with the exception of King George. But we look at the schedule, and they've beaten the likes of Brentsville District, who won Region 3B and fell last week in the Class 3 state semis to Phoebus, who won the Class 3 championship over Heritage of Lynchburg here earlier this afternoon. They beat a playoff team in James Wood. They beat Liberty Bealton in a shootout, 49-42 midseason. Then they got wins over Fauquier, their rival, Millbrook, John Hanley, and Sharando to go 10-0. They go into the playoffs. They have a rematch in round one with their opening opponent, Heritage of Leesburg, and they win easily. They had a rematch with Millbrook and defeated them easily. And then they had a nail biter for the region championship, beating Loudoun County 35-34. And for some people, they considered that a bit of an upset. They thought that Loudoun County would be the team from that region, that area, to advance to state semifinals Saturday. And then last week, their biggest test, and I think their most impressive win of the year, was knocking out EC Glass, the winner of a very tough Region 4D. 30-14 was the final score in that game. And if we can play the game of Connect Four here, they defeat an EC Glass team who had to beat the Salem team out of Lynchburg, who defeated Louisa in the Region 4D semifinals in the jungle. And of course, we had Louisa here on our game of the week back in late October, that big win over Albemarle. They were a fantastic team. Salem comes in and puts up 54 points and wins. And I think, okay, wow, Salem could go to EC Glass and get a win. That did not happen. EC Glass won the region championship. And then I frankly thought EC Glass would be the opponent for Dinwiddie this week, 2 weeks ago. If you'd asked me, I would have said the Hilltoppers will be here. But no, Kettle Run holds them to 14 points, wins the game by 16, and the Cougars have made the trip here to Liberty University for this afternoon's Class 4 state championship showdown. So for Dinwiddie, there is a culture with head coach Billy Mills. It's been there now for well over a decade plus. There have been a litany of players who have come through that program and have experienced undefeated regular seasons. But you got to go back to the 2013 season. So the classes of 2014, 15, and 16 who have experienced hoisting up a championship trophy when they won back in the 2013 season. These players were not a part of the 2016 state championship team that fell at the last minute to Salem of Lynchburg. And now, 6 years later, after some disappointment of their own, they're finally in a situation to where they have a chance to win the state title. Time now for our national anthem. We will take a quick 60-second timeout as the anthem plays. We're back in 60 on Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West offers quality cleaning services for your HVAC units and can make sure your system's ready for the cold winter nights to come. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. The friendly staff at Massey Wood & West always looks out for your well-being and is working under all CDC guidelines. Need a new duct system? Massey Wood & West can handle that too. Plus, Massey Wood & West is proud to offer Rheem water heaters. So call 355-1721. Ask for Doug or Al. They'll be glad to help you get ready. 355-1721. Massey Wood & West. Online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, fans. It does feel like a Friday night. The sun is down. The clouds here in Lynchburg create a really nice backdrop with the mountains off here to our west. Temperatures have been in the 40s all afternoon. Fans knew it. They came dressed appropriately with their sweatshirts and their coats and their blankets and whatever else they need as the captains are coming out for the coin toss at midfield. Co-captains for Dinwiddie, Savon McDowell, the junior linebacker tight end. Quentin Mankin wearing number 17. And we are ready to see who's going to get the football first. Four total captains on either side. Officials are getting them set and ready. And we'll find out who's going to get the football first. And then Navy Nation will come to its feet. Again, they have traveled very well. I would say there's got to be between 1,000 and 1,500 fans, maybe even 2,000 over on the other side, on the Dinwiddie side of the field. So we await the officials to tell us who is going to get the football first. Most of this season, people who have won the coin toss have elected to defer. They want to let their defense take over first, but more importantly, they want to have that football to start the second half, which is huge either way. if you're down, you need it to get back into the game. And if you're ahead, it gives you a chance to put some more distance between you and your opponent. Neither of these teams have experienced a defeat this season. They come in with a record of 28-0 combined, 14-0 for both teams. Kettle Run has won the toss, and let's see if they have elected to defer. And we continue to wait. Takes a little bit longer as opposed to a usual Friday night game. And now we have it set. Kettle Run has won the toss and they have elected to defer. So it's going to be Harry Dalton and Navy Nation on the field first. Captains shake their hands at the 50. The Kettle Run Cougars are already on their sideline, but the four Dinwiddie captains are now headed back, and that includes Harry Dalton, number six, as they get set to come out and bust that Navy Nation banner. Dinwiddie football, find a way. They have found a way 14 times. They need to do it once more to grab the state championship. Second under head coach Billy Mills, and their first in 9 years. Here come the Generals onto Williams Stadium. 14-0, Class 4 Region B's champions. Winners in the semifinal last week over Warwick, 28-0. And now, ready to kick things off in the Class 4 state championship. We thank you for joining us for the pregame show fueled by Massey Wood and West, fueling Virginia since 1923 at 804-355-1721 and at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. Dinwiddie will get the football first here as we get set for the teams to come out onto the field. Dinwiddie's going to be moving right to left in this first period across your radio dial, PC, tablet, or mobile device. We welcome those of you who are listening on 101.3 FM, 990 AM, Rejoice Richmond. Those of you listening on the live link at rvasportsnetwork.com, at rejoicerichmond.com, on the Rejoice Richmond app, as well as any Alexa-enabled device, just say, Alexa, play Rejoice Richmond. We've got three men back deep for Dinwiddie. And they'll put it down at the 40 and tee it up. The waiting is over. The journey that began in hot late July conditions for opening practices, then scrimmages, then the regular season, four postseason games in the books. And now Andrew Curry, the senior kicker, we'll kick it off to the Generals. The 2022 Class 4 State Championship is underway. High kick, but returnable from about the 3-yard line. Up the middle, 10, 15, runs into a wall at about the 19-yard line. Christian Drumgoole on the return, and they'll say knee falls forward to the 20. So a gain of 17 on the return. Dinwiddie takes over. Harry Dalton and company up first here in Lynchburg. Of course, it's more than just Harry Dalton. Raphael Tucker joining him there in the backfield. Two wide receivers on both sides to start things off. We'll see how many Kettle Run puts up on the front. They're showing a 4-2. And they bring a man in motion to Dinwiddie on first down. Here's Tucker up the middle. Drags a Cougar with him for 3 yards. Gets him to the 23-yard line. And it'll be second down. So Tucker on the carry for three. Quickly to the line. Second down. Tucker goes around the corner and is able to fall forward to the 30. That's a Dinwiddie first down. Another thing Dinwiddie would love to do is control the cadence when they have the football. Oh, check that. There's a late penalty flag on the play, and let's see what it is. And the first penalty of the night is going to go against the Generals. It's a hold. So you can wipe out the first down It's 10 from the spot of the foul, which is going to put them back. Looks like the 15-yard line, so the hold took place at the 25. So second down replay, second down and 15. We're in the first minute of action here in Lynchburg. Some beautiful birds come across and fly over the stadium. Quick handoff up the middle, and not much there. Couple of yards only for Tucker, and it's going to be a third down. Chumley helping out on the stop. You're going to hear the name Abram Chumley a lot for Kettle Run this afternoon. So the football to the 16, and that's going to be a third down and long. They need 14 yards. Dalton and company get the signal. Now he's set. Two wide receivers to the far side. Check that. There's three. Dalton's going to roll the other way. Throw, and it's incomplete. Wide of the mark. Intended for Daniel Smith. Jordan Tapscott, 6'2 defensive back, senior for the Cougars, does a good job there in coverage. Dalton was flushed out of the pocket. He was rolling, but then he actually got flushed out of where he was trying to be. Thanks to a good rush there by Kettle Run, and they forced the punt. Dinwiddie had the first down at the 30, called back due to holding, and now Kettle Run should get fantastic field position with 10:34 to go here in the first period. One man back deep near midfield. Here comes the punt. It's high, but it's short. And it'll take a brief Dinwiddie bounce onto the Liberty University logo, and they'll down it at the 47-yard line. So Kettle Run takes over at the Dinwiddie 47. And we are less than 2 minutes gone by here in this state Class 4 championship game. It is first down and 10 for the Cougars. Their first shot with the football this afternoon. Chumley turns, fakes the handoff, wants the throw, looks and overthrows his intended receiver, which was Tapscott. He had really two or three different choices. One man had broken deep downfield, but he was looking for the second option in the middle, Tapscott, and it was just over his head, and it'll be second and 10. But not a bad play call when you're already into your opponent's territory on first and 10. See if you can get a good chunk of yards. Now it's second and 10 at the 47 with an offset I formation. Chumley with the handoff, trying to get around right side, and it won't happen. It's a loss of three back to midfield. The defense, led by Savon McDowell, loss of 3 yards, third down. And one of the key players of the game had his first carry tonight. That was Justin Turner. He wears 22. And they tried to attack the Generals side to side, and that just did not work. So now it's third and 13 at midfield. Chumley all by himself. They'll bring Tapscott in motion. They're going to give it to him, and he's going to get stopped for a loss of two. The shovel pass is a negative play, and it's going to be just like that, fourth down. So Tapscott gets a completion, but it's going to be a loss of two. And it'll be fourth down and long, and Dinwiddie's going to get the football right back. Two men back deep for the Generals at about their 15-yard line. 9:12 to go, opening quarter. Both teams go three and out in their first possession. It's fourth and 15, and the kick is away. High kick. Takes a great Kettle Run bounce inside the 10, and they're going to down it at the 9-yard line. So Dinwiddie takes over, but deep in their own territory. No score. 8:55 to go here in period number one. A 43-yard punt and no return. So here comes Dalton and company. First down. Dalton keeps it on the read option and is able to power through for 5 to the 14-yard line to make it 2nd down and 5, and they bounce right back up to the line of scrimmage. No opportunity for the Cougars to make any defensive adjustments. 2nd down, here's Tucker looking to get around right side. He's able to get to the 20. That'll be just enough for the Generals' 1st down. The same play they ran that had a hold a few minutes ago. But this time, it's a gain of 6. So 1st and 10 from the 20. Dalton behind a runner. Goes to the 30, to the 35, inside to the 39-yard line, then jutted it outside right there, got tackled at that point, but that's a gain of 19 for Harry Dalton. And if you're Kettle Run, you do not want to see this high-powered offense get rocking and rolling. 8:13 to go in the first. 1st down, Dinwiddie at the 39-yard line. Dalton gets it to Tucker. Finds running room off left tackle across the 45. He'll approach the 47-yard line, give Raphael about 8 yards on 1st down. And right now, Dinwiddie is finding a way to pick up chunks of yardage. This drive started at the 9. They're ready for the snap. Kettle Run still is not in position. And Dalton will be caught from behind. The defense was not ready, but that is a fantastic individual effort by Peyton Mahaffey, the linebacker, to bring him back to the 44. So it is now 3rd down and 5. Trips to the far side. 3rd down, Dalton wants to throw. Wants it all. Goes down the sideline. He's got a man open. Complete. And inside the 15, down to the 10-yard line. It's Christian Drumgool with a huge reception. They'll mark him down at the 9. 1st and goal, 47 yards. Dalton to Drumgool, and they're ready. As soon as they put that football down, the Generals are in position. 1st and goal from the 9. Dalton going to keep it himself up the 5 and into the end zone. 91-yard drive. Touchdown, Dinwiddie Generals. And the Dinwiddie Generals get on the board first with 7:01 to go in the first period. What an impressive touchdown drive by Dinwiddie. Textbook Dinwiddie. Dalton a bullet to Drumgool to set up the 1st and goal. As we get the point after try, the kick is up, and the kick is good. 7:01 to go, first period. And Dinwiddie strikes first. It's 7-0 Generals. We're back in 60 seconds. This is State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721, Massey Wood & West, online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Let's go. 91-yard touchdown drive capped off by the 9-yard run from Harry Dalton. The extra point attempt from Van Meter is good. It's 7-0 as Kettle Run returns their ensuing kick to the 30-yard line, and that is where Chumbling and Company will get going here on their second possession of the afternoon, but down 7, 6 minutes, 54 seconds to go, first period in the Class 4 State Football Championship. On 1st down, Chumley to the pass, looks over the middle, and overthrows his intended receiver. Again, that was Jordan Tapscott he's trying to get to. And on both opportunities, Tapscott had some separation, but both footballs overthrown. So Chumley early, one of three for negative 2 yards as he had that little shovel pass coming down the middle of the field to tap Scott on third down on the last drive that lost two. Second and 10 at the 30. This time handoff to Turner. Breaks right tackle, gets to the 35. He'll be drug out of bounds at about the 38. Good play there by Trumgool to make sure he didn't get to the line to gain and force a third down. That is the best run so far this afternoon for Kettle Run. They get 7 to the 37. And it'll be third down. Third down, they need 3. Chumley going to keep it himself. And he's not going to make it. Stood up at the line of scrimmage and then backed up by several Dinwiddie generals led by Adrian Parson. Coming out from his defensive back position, it's 4th and 3 at your own 37. We are not even halfway through the first period. I don't think you think about a fourth down, go for it here, or even a fake. And Trumgool is one of two men back deep for Dinwiddie to accept the punt. We'll make sure they actually do punt. And the kick is partially blocked. It is going to go into Dinwiddie territory. They get out of the way. It's going to bounce down to the 33-yard line. So that's going to end up being a 30-yard partially blocked punt and no return. Kettle Run very, very fortunate that that ball was able to get at least a little bit of forward progression. It looked like from our angle, and we are way high above Williams Stadium this afternoon, from our angle, it looked like it might have gone out of bounds near midfield, but it kept rolling in bounds, and they're going to mark it down officially at the 32. So that's where the Generals take over, up by 7. First down and 10 at their own 32-yard line. Dalton brings a man in motion. It's a jet sweep. Nope, fake on the jet sweep. Dalton's going to find running room off left tackle. He gets away from a second defender and finally brought down near the 41-yard line. It's going to be a gain of close to 9 yards. And there's where you see the physicality of Harry Dalton. He has no problem lowering the pads, accepting the hit, and winning the fight. Getting to that second and third would-be tackler before he's brought down. Second and short, pitch to Tucker. He'll get to the 44, and that'll be enough to move the chain. First down. Dinwiddie, gain of 3, and it's second down, already 67 rushing yards for Dinwiddie in this first period, and just over 100 yards of total offense, thanks to the big play Dalton to Drumgool. We've got 5 wide and a penalty marker as Dalton's going to draw the nose guard offside, so encroachment against Kettle Run. And it'll be first down and 5 at the 49 with 5 minutes to go in period number 1. Welcome all of our friends listening tonight live on Rejoice 101.3 FM and 990 AM and listening live online at rejoicerichmond.com and rvasportsnetwork.com. Tucker beside Harry Dalton, he'll get the carry, get hit immediately, push his way forward to midfield or just into Kettle Run territory. Officials coming in, marking it at the 49. So Tucker's 7th carry net. And 3 after the penalty and then the 2-yard rush. Just into Kettle Run territory at the 49, 4:30 to go, clock running, first period. Dalton trying to set up a screen. It's complete. It'll be Drumgool, and he'll get the first down. He's able to get himself to the 40 and then fall forward to the 38-yard line. That's a gain of 11. So 2 for 2 for 58 here early. And back to the line they are. First down. Dalton all by himself just nails a player. We get a penalty marker down. Harry's going to get inside the 20, but this is coming back. There's going to be either a hold or a block in the back at about the 30, 31-yard line. But the first would-be tackler for the Cougars, Dalton, just gave him the stiff arm a la Derrick Henry, and he was off. But this one, unfortunately for general fans, gained close to 20 yards, is going to come back on the second big penalty of the afternoon. Wait a minute. They have waved off the penalty. They are picking up the flag. And they will mark the football at the Kettle Run 18-yard line. That will be a Dalton rush of 20. Ah, okay, they're not picking up the flag. It is a face mask against the Cougars. And that's going to put the football all the way down to the 9-yard line. It is first and goal, Generals up 7-0, 4 minutes to go in the first. Tucker gets the call across the five, brought down from behind at the 4-yard line by Mahaffey. Second and goal at the 4, and quickly to the line they come. Dalton calls his own number, looking for a second score of the game, and he'll get it. Diving across the goal line into the red of the end zone. Touchdown, Dinwiddie Generals. 3:41 to go in the first period. And the Generals could not have asked for a better start in this state championship. Second touchdown run of the day for Dalton. This one of 4 yards. Now the point after try from Jackson Van Meter. Kick is up, and the kick is good. 14-0 Dinwiddie. Navy Nation coming alive across the way here in Lynchburg. And we're back in 30 seconds. This is state championship Saturday. On Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
So that drive, capped by a 4-yard touchdown run, the second touchdown run of the day for Dalton. Line drive, ensuing kick taken at the 13, up to the 25, tripped up and falling down to about the 29-yard line, the Cougar returner. And it will be 22, Justin Turner for Dinwiddie, who picks up the tackle. And now the Cougars getting their third possession of the afternoon, starting at their own 28-yard line. You'll remember they started their first drive just inside Dinwiddie territory and went backwards. And now they're down 14 early. On first down, Chumlee's going to keep it himself, finds running room, off left tackle, gets across the 35 to the 36-yard line. And for Chumlee, that will be a gain of 8 to make it second down and 2. Abram Chumlee is 6'2", 205, so he's got power. He doesn't have the speed of Dalton, but he's definitely got the power and is not afraid to do what he has to do in the running game. He's by himself right now on second down. Inside handoff and falling forward close to first down yardage on the carry is Mahaffey. And it's going to depend upon the spot. It will be enough. Gain of 2, first down, Cougars. So the Cougars get some working room here. 2:45 clock running, first quarter. Dinwiddie 14, Kettle Run nothing. Cougars first down at their own 38. Chumlee to throw. Has time, screen developing, complete, 40. And out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Catch made by Colton Quaker. So with 2:31 to go in the first period, it'll be a gain of 7. So second down and 3, and the first pass completion for positive yardage this afternoon. Second and 3 at the 45. Handoff and nothing there off right tackle. Dinwiddie wins that battle without a problem, led by Alexander Elmore coming in from the linebacking spot to create a wall. No gain, third down. So Quaker unofficially early tonight, 3 carries, 4 yards. We're coming up on 2 minutes to go in the first. Night falling over beautiful Lynchburg, Virginia. And Dinwiddie looking for another stop, already up 14-0. Third down, offset I formation. Chumley will roll, get a block, look, and then he'll go down at the 41-yard line. The general defense comes alive, and we get a late penalty flag well after the play. So hold everything. If this was frustration on Kettle Run, it'll just pin him back for a deep punt. If Dinwiddie did a little jacking and John, it's going to be a first down for Kettle Run into Dinwiddie territory. Let's see what happens. The head referee, dead ball, personal foul against Kettle Run. And it'll be fourth down. I was waiting to see if he was going to say there was also a personal foul on Dinwiddie, and it would have been offset, dead ball, didn't matter, it's fourth down and 3. But now it's fourth down and a whole lot more than that, and Dinwiddie is going to get the football back in good field position, and Kettle Run has no choice but to punt. That's some of the mistakes that can be made by a team that's never been at this level of competition before. You let a little frustration get underneath you, and the next thing you know, it cost your team 15 yards. So two Dinwiddie Generals back near their 35-yard line. High snap. The kick is away, and boy, it was almost blocked. Partially blocked the last time. That'll take a Kettle Run bounce and go out of bounds at the Dinwiddie 42-yard line. Great defense on that third down throw that ends up being a quarterback sack. And the Generals are salivating right now. First down, 1:31 to go. And here come the Generals. First down, handoff on the jet sweep. Drumgool trying to get around, and good job there by the Cougar defense to just string that play out. And it'll be Chumley who comes out to make the tackle at the 43-yard line. And it'll be just a gain of a yard. Second down, 9 yards to go. 1:05 to go in period one, 14-0 Dinwiddie. Dalton looking to throw. Got a screen complete, 45 to midfield, and that'll be close to first down yardage. The catch made by Wiggins. It'll be a gain of 7 and bring up a third down and a yard. They'll go quickly to the line. Dalton calls his own number, breaks away, 35, 30, 25, and first down near the red zone at the Kettle Run 29-yard line. So Dalton on short yardage is able to find running room right side, and they're going to call him down at the 20. That is 31 yards. First down at the Kettle Run 20. Final 30 seconds of the first period, dominated by Dinwiddie. Inside handoff, cutting it up the middle, Drumgool, and he'll grab 2 yards to the 18-yard line. It's been all Dinwiddie in quarter number one. After one tonight from Lynchburg, the Dinwiddie Generals 14, the Kettle Run Cougars nothing. We're back in 60 seconds on State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721, Massey Wood & West, online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information. Baby,
the Dinwiddie Generals were stalled in their opening drive, then the three and out by Kettle Run, and since then, it's been Dinwiddie on a roll. Big plays, two touchdown runs from Harry Dalton, and a big Dalton run, which puts him at near 100 yards rushing in the first period alone. We'll bring him to the Kettle Run 20. The inside handoff to Drumgoole for two to end the quarter. It is second and eight. Dinwiddie at the Kettle Run 18-yard line, up 14-0. Rob Witham along with you live here from Williams Stadium on the campus of Liberty University. Dinwiddie looking for their second state championship in the last decade. Their first since 2013. Dalton going to keep it himself on the read option and gets hit at the line of scrimmage and immediately brought down. Excellent pursuit by Kettle Run. Mason Fletcher in there helping Mahaffey on the stop. It's no gain. And now an interesting play call here. Third down and eight at the Kettle Run 18. We'll see what the Generals dial up here. Tucker to the left of Dalton. They'll pitch it to Raphael. He'll get a block and get the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Gain of 9. First and goal. Generals. And Dinwiddie right now threatening to put some serious distance between them and the Cougars. First and goal from the 9. Tucker will cut up the middle and get down to the 6-yard line. His 10th carry by our count this afternoon. Going to get it down to the 7. So a gain of 2. And it'll be second down and goal from the 7. Second and goal at the 7. Dalton's going to call his own number. Off right tackle inside the 5 and down to the 2. Gain of about 5 to set up third down and goal. 10:38 to go, first half. 14-0 Dinwiddie looking for more. Third and goal at the 2. Is it Tucker or is it Dalton? Well, we're about to find out. Third and goal. It's Tucker, and he's in. Touchdown, Dinwiddie Generals. Raphael Tucker from 2 yards out, and it's 20-0, Dinwiddie. 10 minutes, 18 seconds to go. Here in the first half, and the Generals are on a roll. Van Meter's extra point attempt is up, and it is good. 10 minutes, 18 seconds to go in the first half. Your score, Dinwiddie 21 and Kettle Run nothing. And one of the big storylines here in this one early on, fans, is I know that this Dinwiddie team, the players on this team have not been at this stage. But this program has twice in the last decade, and every year when they hit the pads in July, they believe they can make it to this level. It is a program that expects to be here. For Kettle Run, this is historic. This is their first time on the biggest stage in the VHSL. And it has shown, as this first half has kind of worked itself into this second period. 21 points unanswered by Dinwiddie. Ensuing kick taken at the 15-yard line. Coming up the middle, 20. 25, and again, third consecutive return where Kettle Run's going to start at about their 29 or 30-yard line. And then the Cougars will take over first and 10, but they look at the scoreboard The saving grace is they need to not worry about what it says on the score as much at this moment as the fact that we are only a little over a quarter into the game. So there is plenty of time to get your offense going, get some defensive stops, and get right back into it. First and 10 for Chumlee. Fake the handoff, looking over the middle, pass is tipped and incomplete. Intended for Mahaffey, it was a little high but definitely catchable. And it'll be second down. And Abram Chumlee, it seems to be, I'm going to put it in as nerves. Being on this big stage, you know, teams at the high school level, they really don't get to play in stadiums this size. And you wonder if maybe that might be an issue for him. Second and 10. Calls his own number, quarterback right up the middle, across the 35, down to the 37-yard line. That'll be a gain of 7. And it'll be third down. Dinwiddie, head coach Billy Mills, mentioned on his interview with my buddy Gary Hess on their Class 5 radio broadcast earlier this afternoon, mentioned that they were able to go to Virginia State and do some practicing this week to kind of get a feel for how it would be to be here in this one, in this stadium. Third and short, handoff, and it ain't happening. It's not happening. 22, Colton Quaker gets to the left tackle, and then he is stood up at the 37. No gain. And on fourth down, it is another three and out for Dinwiddie, and the Generals are going to get the football up 21-0 as the clock approaches the 9-minute mark. Zaylin Wiggins and Christian Drumgoole back deep at about their 27-28-yard line. It is fourth and short. Would Kettle Run consider a fake here? 8:45 left in the half. Penalty marker comes in to stop the play, and they were going for the fake. The punter went back to pass, and there was a man wide open near midfield. Trey Westren, senior wideout, had gone out, and it's going to be a penalty against Kettle Run. Delay of game. And now they've shown their cards, and they're not going to be able to do what they wanted to do. So the delay of game penalty cost them much more than 5 yards. That would have been an easy first down into Dinwiddie territory, and now the Cougars are going to have to kick. Kick is away, high, short, heading toward the far sideline, going to take a Dinwiddie bounce and be downed just inside Kettle Run territory near the 49, maybe the 50. We'll get the official look in a second. But boy, if you're Kettle Run, you're just shaking your head right now, heading back to the sideline going, we had him wide open, but it took us too long to get the playoff. And those are mistakes that you can make in week one, week two, but not week 15. Can't do that. And Dinwiddie gets the ball at midfield, up 21, looking for more. First down, Dalton. Tucker, around right side, breaks a tackle, gets down the sideline, 25, 20, 15, and down near the 12. Touchdown saving tackle from Colton Quaker. 38 yards for Tucker. And between Dalton and Tucker, they're at close to 200 rushing yards. Right back to the line they come, first and 10 at the 12. They can get a first and goal at the 2. Back to Tucker around left side, gets good blocking, gets inside the 5, keeps pushing, and is finally brought down near the 1. Unbelievable. Raphael Tucker took 2 or 3 Cougars for a ride. And it'll be first and goal. Gain of 11. They're at the 1. 8:01 to go. First half. 21-0. Looking for more. Dalton. Tucker. Touchdown. Dinwiddie Generals. Everything clicking on all cylinders. For the Region 4B champions. It's 27-0. With 7:56 to go. In the first half. Navy Nation across the way is going bonkers. Point after try coming. It's up. and it's good. Dinwiddie 28, Kettle Run nothing. Still 7:56 to go in the half, and we're back in 30 seconds. This is State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
Well, as we like to tell you here each week on the broadcast, our stats are painfully unofficial. We'll get official stats at the half, but we have Dalton and Tucker both approaching 100 yards of rushing offense as the ensuing kick taken by Kettle Run at the 15, trying to get around the near side, gets to the 30 and then out of bounds at about the 32-yard line, and the Cougars will start at the 33 officially, first down, but they look at the clock now. And I mentioned a minute ago, they didn't need to focus on the score as much as they did the clock and realize how much time is left in this game. But now that it's 28-0 rather than 21-0, you've got to take it all in and realize two things. Number one, for the players who play defense only, you need to give them a break. And number two, you got to figure out how to get this offense going. Chumley in the shotgun on first and 10. Handoff. And maybe a yard to the 34. And that is going to be all as Quaker is pushed back after the one-yard gain. That's just patience there by the Dinwiddie defense on the right side just to stay home and take care of business. Give 42 Khalil Parham, the junior, the initial stop on that one. Second down and 9. 7:15 to go in the first half. Dinwiddie up 28-0. Handoff. Quaker gets hit at the 35. Spins, but will be stopped there. Another one-yard gain. This time they try to go off right tackle. And again, Dinwiddie sniffing it out. Damari Phillips is over there on the end of that line on the left side. Joshua Adams, the freshman out there as well. So third and 8 at the 35. 6:40 to go in the half. Cougars down 28. Chumley to throw. It's caught. Looking for a block and will not get it. It'll be a completion of a yard, but Adrian Parson comes up and just grabs the receiver and pushes him backwards. And it'll be fourth down. And again, Kettle Run sends out the punting unit. And now you got to wonder maybe at this particular point if they might just go for broke and go for the fake here. But Dinwiddie's going to be sniffing it out. Two men back at the 33-yard line. Punt is away, angling toward the sideline, and it'll go out of bounds right at the 30-yard line. So another three and out for the Kettle Run offense that they have just not been able to get anything going. And it'll be Generals ball at their own 30 with 5 minutes and 44 seconds left in the half. Coming up at halftime, presented by Virginia Family Dentistry, we're going to take a few moments and stroll down memory lane and remember some of the incredible moments of this, our 20th anniversary season on radio. We began at Metoaka High School back in August, and we conclude here in Lynchburg in December. It's coming up at the half, presented by Virginia Family Dentistry. At the 30, first and 10, it'll be a sweep, cutting up the right there on the left hash is going to be Wiggins, and he'll get to the 34. So that's a gain of 4. It'll be second down and 6. Dalton looking for the play call from the sideline. No huddle. They get back to the line. They look up. They get the play, and now they're ready. 5:15 to go. Wiggins in motion, now turns behind Dalton. They'll give it to Raphael Tucker, but not much there. He'll get a yard to the 35. So, third down and 5 at the 35. And we have an official's timeout here with 5:03 to go in a half. I don't see a injured player, and now they've asked the clock to restart. So there it goes. Third down and 5 at the 35, under 5 minutes left in the half. Will number 5 get this one? Or will number 6 keep it himself? Low snap, Dalton looking to throw, flushed out of the pocket, throws, and it is complete, but short of the first down. He'll get stopped 2 yards short at the 38-yard line. He's looking to see who caught that football. So Justin Turner on the catch, but he's going to be just shy of the first down. And so for the first time since their opening drive stalled because of a holding penalty, the Generals will have to punt. And there is no one back deep for Kettle Run. End over end kick. It'll take a neutral bounce, then pop back in Kettle Run's direction. And the Generals will finally down it at the 40-yard line with 3 minutes and 54 seconds to go in the first half. First and 10, Kettle Run at their own 39-yard line, but down 28 to nothing. If you missed it earlier this afternoon, congratulations to Highland Springs, their second 15-0 season in 5 years, and their first state championship in 4, their 5th in 8 seasons, winning over Maury today in Norfolk, 33-19. Chumley looking to throw. Now the pressure comes, and he goes down. It'll register as a sack, a loss of 1. Back to the 38-yard line. McDowell, Christopher Bowles, both a part of the sack attack for Dinwiddie. Loss of 1, 2nd and 11, 3:30 to go until halftime. Two wide to the far side, 1 to the near. Chumley looking to throw. Slant pattern incomplete. Great coverage there by Quentin Mankin. He was there at the exact same time the ball arrived, and the intended receiver just couldn't put a hand on it. So make it 3rd down and 12. Pass was intended for Rogers, and he'll go to the far side. Too wide here to the near on 3rd and long. Cougars to throw. Chumley got his man this time in stride, inside the 30 and out of bounds at the 25-yard line. He's been waiting all day to hit that slant pass to Jordan Tapscott, and he gets it. And it'll be a gain of 37, and the Cougars have their best field position of the evening so far. 3:08 to go in the half, desperately needing a score. Down 28-0. Cougars will get the football to start the second half. 3 wide here to the near side on 1st down. Chumley wanted to throw, and now he's going to tuck it and run. He'll get to the 22. It'll be a gain of 3 and 2nd down coming up. We go under 3 minutes remaining in half number 1. Dinwiddie 28, Kettle Run nothing. 2 touchdown runs for Raphael Tucker, 2 touchdown runs for Harry Dalton. 2nd down and 7. Chumley looking, wants Tap Scott, does a double move. He's open in the end zone, and he's got it. Touchdown, Kettle Run. Quentin Mankin got juked on that double move and fell down. And Tapscott was all alone, and the Cougars get on the board with 2:25 to go in the half to make it 28-6. The They will go for the point after try. Trying to make it 28-7. Andrew Curry, his kick is up, and the kick is no good. He missed it. So it is Dinwiddie 28, Kettle Run 6, 2:25 to go to the half. We're back in 30 seconds on State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721, Massey Wood & West, online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
You're listening to WREJ Richmond, W267 CB Richmond, with the best producer on the planet, Alvin Cecil, back in the Rejoice Studios on Three Chop Road in beautiful Richmond, Virginia. Rob Witham, honored to be with you here from Liberty University. Dinwiddie 28, Kettle Run 6, Class 4 State Championship. The Cougars kick it away to the Generals, 2:25 to go in the half, taken at the 10 by Drumgoole. Up the middle, 20, 25, gets around the corner, 30, 35, and then slung out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. So that was a patient piece of running by Christian Drumgoole to pick up good yardage and give Dalton and company good field position. 2:17 and all three timeouts remaining, up 28-6. And yes, you do not lay off the accelerator here. If you're Dinwiddie, you do what you've been doing all day, because you don't want to give Kettle Run an opportunity to crawl back into this one. And off to Tucker, looking to get around the far side. He does. 45-50, 45, and out of bounds. Into Kettle Run territory, Raphael Tucker, over 100 yards of rushing in this first half. He has two of the four Dinwiddie scores, and he's got them in Kettle Run territory at the 47. They stop the clock long enough to move the chain. 2:09 to go, first and 10. Clock restarts. Generals do too. Dalton going to keep it himself this time. Fall forward to the 42-yard line for a gain of 5 to make it 2nd and 5. 2 minutes clock running here in the first half. Again, Dinwiddie leading 28-6. Kettle Run gets the ball to start the third quarter. So you would love to take almost the rest of these 2 minutes away. You've got three timeouts to work with if you need them, to try to put some more points on the board before you hand the ball back to the Cougars in period number 3. 2nd and 5. Dalton looking to throw. Got a man wide open. Drumgoole. He can walk into the end zone. Busted coverage. Touchdown. Dinwiddie Generals. 42 yards. That was too easy. Drumgoole got behind the defense, and there was not a white jersey to be found within 30 yards of Christian. He caught it at about the 12, and he could have crawled into the end zone, only a knee down would have ended the play. Holy cow, what a counterpunch. Extra point attempt up, and it is good. 1 minute, 29 seconds to go in the first half. And the Generals are rocking and rolling. It's 35-6 Dinwiddie, and we're back in 30 seconds on State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721, Massey Wood & West, online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Ensuing kickoff, nice play individually by special teams from Alex Elmore, slinging down the returner at the 25-yard line. 1:23 to go in the half. Kettle Run gets the football back with three timeouts. They get the football to start the third quarter, but they are down by 29 points. 35-6 Dinwiddie. If you're wondering, the most points Dinwiddie scored in a game this year, 63, and they did it twice. Chumley looking to throw. Got Tap Scott, complete, 35-40, 45, and down to the 48-yard line. And the Cougars are going to have to go wide open here. No tight formations, five wide, sling that football. And it's very obvious that Jordan Tap Scott is the big target for Abram Chumley. That's a gain of 23 to the 48-yard line. 1:10 to go, clock running. Chumley to throw again. Looking. Now throws. Got a man wide open. Complete at the Dinwiddie 32-yard line. Peyton Mahaffey does a great job of coming back to Chumley. And the defender for Dinwiddie didn't know it was coming. But we have a penalty marker on the field to stop the clock at exactly 1 minute to go. So hang on. Kettle Run is pointing in Dinwiddie's direction. If that be the case, it could be a completion and more yards. But the conversation with the officiating crew continues right at midfield. 1 minute left, first half, 35-6, Dinwiddie with the lead. Two Dalton TD runs, two Tucker TD runs, and just a few minutes ago, Dalton's touchdown pass to a wide-open Christian Drumgoole. And now here comes the call. It will be a personal foul against Dinwiddie. And so the play will stand. And that should put it down 15 more yards from the 33 to the 18. So just like that, Kettle Run is in the red zone with 1 minute to go and three timeouts. Down 35-6. So Chumley and company ready to go as soon as the official gives them the signal. Back judge now backpedals out of the way. First down from the 18. Chumley looking incomplete. Dropped. His intended receiver, 34, Connor Adair, was just kind of dribbling out from an H-back position and was wide open and would have had some running room. Probably would have gotten toward the 10. But just dropped the football. Second down and 10. Kettle Run in the red zone of the Dinwiddie 18. It's 35-6 Generals. 55 seconds left in this first half. Kettle Run looking for a spark that they can build momentum into half number two. Chumley to throw. Wants it all in the corner. And it's for Tap Scott, and we're going to get flags. He got held near the goal line by Quentin Mankin. So that's going to be pass interference, and they're going to mark it off half the distance to the goal. That'll be to the 9-yard line with 51 seconds to go. Again, coming up, halftime report presented by our friends at Virginia Family Dentistry. So thankful for their title sponsorship of the 2022 high school football season here on Rejoice and the RVA Sports Network. 16 Metro Richmond locations to serve you. You need a dentist for anything from your child's first appointment ever to wisdom teeth, braces, dental surgery, just a checkup. VADentist.com. Go there right now. VADentist.com. From the 9, inside handoff and nothing doing there. A loss of 1 back to the 10, and Kettle Run will call timeout. with 40 seconds remaining. So Quaker got the handoff and went absolutely nowhere. They'll back that football up a yard to the 10, 40 seconds left, first time out taken by the Cougars. Big, big thank you to Virginia Family Dentistry, as well as our friends at Massey Wood & West, who bring you the pregame show each week this season, for their support here in 2022 to bring you some pretty doggone exciting action. And we'll talk about a little bit of what we have seen and experienced in this, our 20th anniversary season on radio, and our second season with our friends at Rejoice Richmond, 101.3 FM, 990 AM. In case in the midst of the end of the game I forget, a huge word of thanks to Jim Jacobs, who took us in last year, both our high school package and our Randolph-Macon College football coverage, to give us a great signal in the Richmond area. And we've been so grateful to work with them for 2 years and many years to come. Out of the timeout from the 10, Chumley over the middle, touchdown, Kettle Run. Guess who? It's Samuel Rogers off the right side getting the score. Thought maybe he was going to look for Tapscott all the way, but instead he finds Rogers, and it's 35-12 with 34 seconds left. And the point after try coming from Andrew Curry. Seven touchdowns between the two teams in this first half. Extra point up. This one's good. Dinwiddie 35, Kettle Run 13 with 34 seconds left in half number one. Winner finishes 15-0 and claims the Class 4 state football championship. Dinwiddie looking to make it a 2-for-2 day for the 804. As earlier today, Highland Springs, I mentioned this on Twitter at Henrico Sports after the game ended. I have never seen a team take advantage of the last 6 minutes of the second period like the 2022 Highland Springs Springers. They were down in Charlotte. We had that game live here, 14-0. They scored 20 in that time frame to take the lead at the half, a lead they never relinquished, winning that game over Chambers on the fourth and goal line stand at the one-yard line. They scored 14 points in the last 13 seconds of the half at Colonial Forge to make a 7-0 game, a 21-0 game, and they rolled from there. Today, they're down 7-6. What do? Two touchdowns, final half of the second period. They led at the half 18-7 and went on to a 33-19 win. Incredible year for Coach Lauren Johnson and the Springers. Ensuing kick taken at the 16, Dinwiddie near the 30, and that's where the play will finally come to an end, and the clock will stop with 26 seconds to go. So I'm going to tell you, folks, the way the Generals' offense has been rolling here this afternoon, 26 seconds, three timeouts, 70 yards, it can be done. Don't put anything past Harry Dalton and this Generals' offense. I do not believe they're going to be satisfied and take a knee and go into the locker room. Here they come out of the closest thing they've shown to a huddle all day. At the 30, quick pass, complete, and out of bounds near the 37-yard line. And we're going to get it. Is that a penalty flag at the end of that play? I believe there might be, as Zaylen Wiggins was wrestled down at the 37 by Rogers. And Navy Nation immediately reacted at how the play ended. But no, they have picked up the flag. And the clock is at 20 seconds to go. A gain of 7 to the 37. Now, what you don't want to do is have a turnover here and give Kettle Run a chance to put maybe even 3 on the board before the break. 5 wide. Alton throwing long. Looking for Drumkuhl, double coverage, he's got it! He's inside the 30, timeout Dinwiddie. With 13 seconds to go, I told you they could do it. Timeout Generals. 33 yards on the pitch and catch, and what a first half for Christian Drumkuhl. They will be working from the Kettle Run 30. They will have 13 seconds and two timeouts, so they can do anything. They don't have to hit the sideline. They could go over the middle. If they want to get close, then maybe try a field goal. Or they can take a couple of shots into the end zone. But even if you fall short, you can immediately call a timeout. Two, maybe a third play, but one of those plays, if you're going to get three in the last 13 seconds, it's got to be pretty quick. That's when you throw, you know, if you get down to like the 20 and you got 9 seconds to go, you do a 5 or 6 yard out to give you a better shot at the end zone. Let's see what they dial up. Tucker to the right of Dalton, three wide to the far side at the 30. 13 seconds to go. Dalton over the middle, overthrows his intended receiver. Looking for Mankin, and that's the first pass that Dalton has just been off on all afternoon. So 8 seconds to go. They won't have time to use both their timeouts, but they'd love to get a chunk of yardage here, call timeout, and get one shot at the end zone. Or do they just go for one shot here? Let's see. Three here to the near, one to the far at the Kettle Run 30. Dalton back to throw, looking, caught at the 14. They need a timeout. They get it with 2 seconds to go. Guess who? Drumgoole with the 16-yard reception. So with 2 seconds to go, here comes Jackson Van Meter and the field goal unit. They officially put the football on the right hash at the 15-yard line. So they drive 55 yards in 24 seconds. And they're going to give Van Meter an opportunity from the right hash for what should be about a 32-yard field goal. Dalton will kneel down just in front of that hash mark at the 22. 32-yard try for Jackson Van Meter to end the first half. Snaps good, holds good. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Jackson Van Meter from 32 yards. We've hit the half in the Class 4 State Football Championship, and the Dinwiddie Generals go to the locker room, leading by 25. It is Dinwiddie 38, Kettle Run 13. We are going to take a four-minute timeout. Fans, hang with us. The halftime report presented by Virginia Family Dentistry is coming up next. We'll take a walk down memory lane of what's been a spectacular 20th anniversary season of high school football Friday night, ending it here on State Championship Saturday. The Generals up big at the break at Liberty University. We're back in 4 minutes. This is State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West offers quality cleaning services for your HVAC units and can make sure your system's ready for the cold winter nights to come. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. The friendly staff at Massey Wood & West always looks out for your well-being and is working under all CDC guidelines. Need a new duct system? Massey Wood & West can handle that too. Plus, Massey Wood & West is proud to offer Rheem water heaters. So call 355-1721. Ask for Doug or Al. They'll be glad to help you get ready. 355-1721. Massey Wood & West. Online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Today, people with disabilities can achieve a better life experience With Able Now, a tax-advantaged savings account specifically designed for people with disabilities, Able Now accounts help eligible individuals save and invest their own money without endangering certain disability benefits. Learn if you or someone you know is eligible for an Able Now account at able-now.com. This message is provided by Able Now, administered by Virginia 529.
Clear the road. We have supplies inbound.
Are you a problem solver? The Air National Guard never shies from tomorrow's problems. We run to them. Ready for world-class military training and global missions? Help us design the blueprint for a better future. Serve close to home and build the life you want with the Air National Guard. Visit us at goang.com/now or call us at 1-800-TOGO-ANG.
Did you know that people born from 1945 to 1965 have the highest rates of hepatitis C, but most don't know they're infected? People can live for decades without symptoms, but over time, hepatitis C can cause serious health problems, including liver damage and even liver cancer. If you were born from 1945 to 1965, the CDC recommends that you get a blood test for hepatitis C. So talk to your doctor about getting tested. It could save your life. A message from the CDC.
A veteran's hope. Where are you hiding? I search for you in the seconds, the minutes of each and every day. Hear me as I call out to you. Take my hand. Lift me up as I lift up others. Welcome me home, Father, Mother, Sister, Brother, Son, Daughter. Hear us now. Alone we stood, divided we fell. No longer. Now we choose to make the connection. Our new mission lies within. Visit maketheconnection.net to learn more.
Welcome to the Halftime Report, presented by Virginia Family Dentistry, the team approach to dental care with over 60 dental specialists serving you across the RVA, 16 metro area locations. If you need a dentist for your child, if you need a new dentist, if you're looking at wisdom teeth, or maybe you're looking at root canal or surgery, whatever the case may be, Virginia Family Dentistry is built for an entire lifetime. VADentist.com is where you start your search. VADentist.com. Well, we're at the half at Williams Stadium on the campus, the beautiful campus of Liberty University in Lynchburg, Virginia. And the Dinwiddie Generals in the locker room enjoying a 38-13 lead over Kettle Run in this battle of 14-0 football teams. Dinwiddie was 3-and-out on their first possession due to a first down being erased by a holding penalty. They had to punt the football. Their next five possessions ended with touchdowns as they broke open. First score, Harry Dalton on a 9-yard run after he had connected on a 47-yard pass to Christian Drumgoole. That made it 7-0 with 7 minutes to go in the first period. 3-and-out Kettle Run. Dinwiddie gets the football back. 7 plays, 68 yards in 2 minutes and 6 seconds. Dalton rushes it in from 4 yards, 14-0 after one. Next possession, 9 plays, 58 yards. It starts in the first. It ends in the second period on a 2-yard run from Raphael Tucker. 21-0 the score, 10-18 to the half. And then another Kettle Run 3-and-out. Dinwiddie gets the football back. 3 plays, 50 yards, 39 seconds. Tucker from a yard out, and it was 28-0. Then Kettle Run finally gets a defensive stop, forces a punt, and they have a 5-play, 60-yard drive that took just under 90 seconds. Tapscott got the 22-yard touchdown pass from Chumley. The point after failed to make it 28-6. And then a busted play defensively by Kettle Run. Drumgoole just runs down the right hash, and there wasn't a Kettle Run defender within 30 yards. So Dalton throws, and the pass this was a little bit underthrown because Christian almost had to stop to catch it, but because nobody was near him, it really didn't matter. And he waltzed into the end zone for a 42-yard score. That made it 35-6. And then I tell you, that final minute 29 was wild as Kettle Run takes advantage of a Dinwiddie penalty, goes five plays, 75 yards and 49 seconds. Chumley to Sam Rogers on a touchdown. That's Rogers with a D, by the way, as opposed to the all-time great from Hanover. And it was 35-13, but Dinwiddie got the football at their own 30 with 26 seconds left, and they went 55 yards and five plays, capped by the 32-yard field goal from Jackson Van Meter. And we end the half, Dinwiddie 38 and Kettle Run 13. The Cougars will get the football to start period number two. First downs are 15-7 in favor of Dinwiddie. Dinwiddie has 167 yards of passing offense, 118 yards for Kettle Run. Kettle Run rushing, 14 plays, 18 yards. Dinwiddie, 29 plays, 215 yards. Dalton, 11 carries, 107 yards and two scores. Raphael Tucker, 15 carries, 101 and two scores. And oh, by the way, Harry is 8 of 10 passing for 167 yards. And the touchdown to Drumgool, who has five receptions for 147 yards. Red zone chances, 5 for 5. Time of possession, barely in Dinwiddie's favor by about a minute and a half. So Kettle Run, they get the ball to start the third quarter, and it's going to be critical that they get a touchdown. A field goal, you'll take it, but that's not what you want. That's not what you need in this situation. And you certainly cannot go three and out quickly and give Dalton and company the football right back early third period. This is going to be the most important drive for the Kettle Run Cougars in this 2022 season. They've got to find the end zone to start the third quarter to try to start finding a way to scratch and claw back into this one. 28-0 at one point, 38-13 at the half. Well, folks, what a year. Our 20th anniversary season here on High School Football Friday night, and we began way back late August down at Metoica, with a Metoica win over Glen Allen, and then made the trip down to Charlotte, North Carolina the next day. And we witnessed what ended up being the toughest test of the year for Highland Springs in their 15-0 state championship run that ended earlier today with a 33-19 win over Maury in the Class 5 final down at Old Dominion University. They had to stop Julius Chambers twice on fourth and goal from inside the five in the fourth quarter. The second one came with a minute 42 to go at the one-yard line, where a touchdown would have tied it. The extra point would have given Chambers the lead. And the Springers stopped them, and they got the win 26-20. And that night, my wife went on the trip with me, and I went back to the hotel room that night just so impressed. And I spent a lot of time talking to somebody who knows very little about football, but I just had to talk to somebody about how impressed I was with Highland Springs' grit and their performance that night. And that night I went to bed thinking, yeah, 15-0 state championship is definitely a possibility with this team. And then it only galvanized when we went up. If you'll recall, we didn't have a Friday night game at the end of September because of Hurricane Ian, and the Highland Springs Colonial Forge game that we had originally scheduled had been bumped back to Monday night, and we had that game here. And you'll remember it was 7-0, and it was an uneven first half. And then Christian Martin is able to throw two touchdown passes in the last 13 seconds of the first half, turned a 7-0 scrum into a 21-0 lead, and they took off from there and got the win. And driving home from Fredericksburg that night, I thought to myself, I don't see anybody that can beat them. I really could not. I thought that they would run the table. Their toughest test in the postseason, obviously Stonebridge. They get that defensive stop late last Saturday to win that one, get revenge for the two losses to them in the last 2 years. And then the big win today, 33-19. Congratulations to Highland Springs. We saw the resurgence of Hanover High School under third-year head coach Sam Rogers, and a connection between Bo Sino and Cole Elrod that is kind of difficult to replicate, even at the high school level, where on one play, Bo could throw to Cole, and on the very next play, Cole would throw it to Bo. It just depended upon where the chess pieces were moved in the Sam Rogers offense. Hanover ends up with a fantastic renaissance season at 9-3, losing only to Class 5 champion Highland Springs, at the time defending Class 4 champion Verina, and to what could be Class 4 state champion Dinwiddie in the postseason, finishing 9-3. We had a fantastic defensive battle back in September in Ashland, where Atlee and Patrick Henry, it was 15-13 Patriots at the half, and both teams slugged it out but didn't score in the second. And Coach Ken Wakefield's Patriots held on for a 15-13 slobber knocker back in September. We unfortunately had the COVID issue early in October, but we bounced back from that. We saw Hermitage with a big win, Douglas Freeman with a big win. On the closing night of the regular season, we saw Freeman at home get a big one over Glen Allen, which helped them in postseason seedings in Region 5C. We saw the breakout performances of two incredible freshmen for Louisa, including a young man. If you've not heard the name, Savion Hyder, put it in your back pocket. I believe he will be the number one prospect in the class of 2026 in the Metro RBA area and possibly the Commonwealth of Virginia. And with Louisa coming to Region 5C next year, a lot of you in the RBA are going to get to see him for yourself. So a big win over Albemarle that we had. And of course, in the playoffs, we saw Hanover's heroics over Eastern View. We watched Verina's championship run for back-to-back titles come to an end against King George. And here we are at Liberty University here this evening with the Class 4 state championship game. And right now, Dinwiddie with a 25-point advantage, but Kettle Run will get the football to start the third quarter. Halftime report continues, presented by Virginia Family Dentistry. We're going to take a three-minute timeout, a three-minute break, and when we come back, the team should be back out on the field, and we'll be ready for third quarter action live on a beautiful Saturday night in Lynchburg, Virginia. 38-13 Dinwiddie, back in 3 minutes on State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West offers quality cleaning services for your HVAC units and can make sure your system's ready for the cold winter nights to come. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. The friendly staff at Massey Wood & West always looks out for your well-being and is working under all CDC guidelines. Need a new duct system? Massey Wood & West can handle that too. Plus, Massey Wood & West is proud to offer Rheem water heaters. So call 355-1721. Ask for Doug or Al. They'll be glad to help you get ready. 355-1721. Massey Wood & West. Online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
See that cute little dog in the pet store? Chances are it came from a puppy mill, a breeding facility that forces caged, neglected, and often sick dogs to churn out puppies to be sold for profit. Meanwhile, millions of wonderful, healthy pets end up in animal shelters. But with one simple choice, you can help, just by deciding to adopt instead of purchase your next pet. Not only are you saving a life, you're taking a stand against puppy mills. Visit bestfriends.org/puppymills to learn more.
I promise that you'll never find another like me. I know that I'm a handful, baby.
You are listening to WREJ Richmond, W267CB Richmond, along with Calvin Cecil, producer extraordinaire, back in the Rejoice Studios in the heart of Virginia, the capital city of Richmond. Rob Witham, live at Williams Stadium at Liberty University. As we get set for third quarter action, teams back out on the field. It is Dinwiddie 38, Kettle Run 13. Dinwiddie scored the first 28 points of the game, and then traded scores the rest of the way. getting a 32-yard field goal as time expired to finish up the half at 38 points. But Kettle Run gets the football to start the third period, and as we mentioned, this will by far, it won't even be close, will be Kettle Run's most important offensive possession of the 2022 season. If they really want a chance to get back into this game, they've got to score. And then their defense is going to have to find a way to string together a couple of stops to give the Cougar offense an opportunity to finally get some traction. They began to show it with the two drives late in the second quarter. They were beginning to answer the Generals' defense and figure out a way to move down the field. One drive, they got the beneficiary of a big penalty on Dinwiddie as well. But see if they make halftime adjustments, see how they handle that situation, see if they abandon the running game. Again, 14 carries, 18 yards as a team in the first half. Do they go exclusively to the air? Do they have to maybe run a little bit just so that they can keep play action honest and keep Dinwiddie from just attacking the quarterback play after play after play? A lot of strategy still to be unfolded and a lot of football still left to be played here in Lynchburg. So Kettle Run will get the football down 38-13. We are 24 minutes away from the end of the 2022 high school football season. And one of these two teams is 24 minutes away from hoisting the Class 4 state football championship. And by the way, right before we get started here, third quarter, big thank you to Todd Wetmore here at Liberty University, and to Mike McCall and Chris Robinson and all the great staff up at the Virginia High School League office in Charlottesville in helping us this week to make this state championship broadcast possible. Band meter has it teed at the 40. Kettle Run will move right to left across your radio dial, PC, tablet, or mobile device. Third quarter is underway. Line drive taken at the 10. Up the middle, 15-20, cutting left. Looking for a block, can't find it, down at the 24-yard line. And a great tackle, open field made by McDowell. And it'll be first down, Kettle Run at the 24. And we're underway third quarter. So first and 10, Kettle Run at their 24. Chumley will take the snap, look to pass quickly, and does complete to Tapscott, but only a gain of a yard as he's not able to get to the corner and turn it. Brought down defensively by Howard Spencer. It'll be a gain of a yard, second and 9. They're going to use the short, quick passing game as their running game, it seems. So second down and 9 at the 25. Chumley surveys, takes the snap, but we've got movement on the offensive line. Looks like the left guard will be guilty of a false start. So make it second and 14 from the 20. People ask me what I thought about today's game, and my biggest answer to that has always been twofold. Number one, if Dinwiddie can force Kettle Run into playing their game, and if Dinwiddie can avoid turnovers, they could hoist the trophy. That's exactly what's happened so far. Chumley on second down, plenty of time. Now flushed out of the pocket, and he'll go down at the 20-yard line. So he gets back to the line of scrimmage after the penalty mark off, and it'll be third down and 14 at the 20 with 10:45 to go, third period. Dinwiddie 38, Kettle Run 13, if you're just joining us here on Rejoice 101.3 FM and 990 AM and live on the RVA Sports Network online. Rob Witham, happy to be with you here from Lynchburg on this Saturday evening. Third and long, Chumley to throw, looking, plenty of time. Now he's going to run. Gets to the 25 and brought down there well short of the first down. It'll be fourth down and 9, and Kettle Run has no choice but to kick it away. So the perfect start for Dinwiddie's defense. And the Generals will get the football at It'll be their first possession in the second half. They should get it near midfield. High snap on the kick. They get it away. Low, wobbly, angling toward the Kettle Run sideline, and it will go out of bounds in Kettle Run territory. And it'll be at the 45-yard line. 38-13, we have 9:44 to go here in the third quarter. So first and 10 for Dalton and company at the Kettle Run 45-yard line. Dalton hands off to Tucker. Cuts up the middle left side. Uses the hash marks to get to the 37-yard line, dragging a defender with him for a gain of 8. Again, first half, Dalton ran for 107 yards. Tucker had 101. Second and 2 with the 37 of the Cougars. Dalton will call his own number on the read option. But a good job by the right side of the defensive line there by Kettle Run. Dinwiddie couldn't get any push, and Dalton basically runs into that pile of humanity and goes nowhere. So no gain, third down and 2. Here's Dalton going around right side. We get a penalty marker thrown. He'll get to the 35, but if it's against Dinwiddie, it's coming back. 8:47 left, third period. Let's check the call. Have a feeling it might be holding against Dinwiddie. Let's see. And the penalty mark off against the Generals, and it will be holding against Dinwiddie. They say the hold took place at the 40. That's going to bring the football all the way out to midfield. So it's going to be now third and 15. Generals have got to get to the Kettle Run 35-yard line to move the sticks. So third down and 15, Dinwiddie, right at the 50. Dalton claps his hands once, a second time, fake to Tucker, over the middle, caught! 15-10-5, touchdown, Dinwiddie Generals! Hello, Frank Wells, right up the middle, and the senior wide receiver in stride. A 50-yard strike from Harry Dalton, and the Generals are at 44 points. Holy cow, what a performance. Extra point man meter up, and good. 8:20 to go in the third. Dinwiddie can feel it. It's 45-13, and we're back in 30 seconds on State Championship Saturday. Rejoice, 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
Wow, so what do you do on third and 15? You just call up a bomb right down the middle of the field to a gentleman who hadn't even caught the football yet tonight, Frank Wells. 50-yard touchdown reception, 45-13, and on the ensuing kickoff, the Cougars will take it at the 10, get across the 20, the 25, and down near the 28-yard line. And they've averaged starting between the 24 and the 34-yard line on most every possession tonight. But now they face their biggest deficit of the night. They're down 32 points at 45-13. And we mentioned, you know, coming into the second half, they had to get 7 points on their opening drive. They did not. Dinwiddie makes them pay, and now the deficit is at its biggest tonight. So first and 10 for Chumley and the Cougars. He'll roll right. Now look back left. Got a man across the middle. It's complete near midfield. That'll be first down yardage to the 39-yard line. Pass complete to the tight end, Connor Adair. Should be a gain of, they're going to say, to the 48, a gain of 20. And it'll be first down. I can guarantee you the Cougars will not quit. First and 10 with the offset I formation. Handoff. Breaking one tackle, getting across the 50, and then stood up at about the 47-yard line is Colton Quaker, his best run of the night. Remember, 18 yards on 14 carries for the Kettle Run offense in the rushing game in the first half. So it'll be second down, football at the Dinwiddie 47, second and 5. We go to 7:30 to go here in the third period. Chumley, low snap, handles it well, rolls to his right, looking, gets a good key block. He's going to tuck it and run, get hit at the 45 and get down near the 44. So it'll be a gain of 3 and make it third down and 2 with 7:10 remaining. Don't see a sense of urgency or hurry up right now with Kettle Run, and I would think you'd start to see some here as we get closer and closer to the midway point of the third quarter, down by 32 points. Third and 2, Chumley to throw, looking, toss, complete, and it'll be just enough as Colton Quaker gets the first down, wrestled out of bounds near the Dinwiddie 40. So they needed 2, and they got 4, and they moved the chain. It's first and 10, Kettle Run at the Dinwiddie 40-yard line. Generals up 45-13 with 6:44 to go here in the third period. Chumley with the offset eye formation to his left out of the pistol. Handoff. Quaker looking for some room. He's going to get 4 to the 36-yard line. Again, as we mentioned earlier, they kind of have to do a few running plays to keep the front 7 of Dinwiddie honest. Because if you abandon that completely, you set up a situation where Dinwiddie can just start bringing 5, 6, 7 and dare Chumley to find somebody. Second and 6 at the 36. Chumley to throw. Looking deep. Into double coverage, and it's incomplete. It was a little bit high. I'm not quite sure that that was catchable. Down at about the 7-yard line. He was looking for Tapscott. And the safety converged with the defensive back there for Dinwiddie to create double coverage as the ball arrived. And I think he got a fingertip on it, but it was a little bit too high to really bring back down as Tapscott skied as high as he could. 6:07 to go in the third. Now third and 6 at the Dinwiddie 36. Back to throw. Chumley again. Looking. Plenty of time. Pumps. Now wants to tuck it and run. And that's when the pocket collapses. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that is all. Drumgoole defensively making his presence known. Damari Phillips as well. 6'2", 210-pound sophomore linebacker. There are some critical seniors on this Dinwiddie team, but my goodness, if they got a load of guys coming back next year. Here it is, fourth down and 6. You're at the Dinwiddie 36. If you're Kettle Run, you got to go for it. But the play clock's down to 10. On fourth down, they need the 30-yard line. Here's Chumley looking, throwing, got a man at the 15. It's Tapscott, and he'll sky high, catch it, fall down there, first down. Kettle Run in the red zone. Officially at the 16-yard line, that's a 20-yard gain. The Cougars scratching, clawing, and fighting. Down 45-13, 5:15 left, third period. Here in the 2022 Class 4 State Championship, Dinwiddie trying to make it back-to-back state titles in Class 4 from the 804. First down, Chumley to throw, got all day, flips it, complete, Tapscott gets hit at the 12 and brought down there. It'll be a gain of 4. Hard hit on that tackle. And the officials are going to call timeout. And they're going to, bring, that looks like, Joshua Adams out of the game to be looked at to make sure he is okay and doesn't have to go into concussion protocol, because that was a very hard hit he laid on Tapscott to limit it to a 4-yard gain. So 2nd and 6 at the 12. We go under 4:45 to go, third period. And I'm telling you, they shouldn't be going under 8 on the play clock, but they are. Chumley inside handoff, up the middle inside the 5, and down to the 2-yard line goes Peyton Mahaffey. It'll be 1st and goal, Kettle Run. They've tried that inside handoff a couple of times tonight to no avail. That time they got the look they wanted, and they were able to get that seam up the middle. And Mahaffey does the rest. The football will go to the 2. It's 1st and goal, Kettle Run. Kettle Run gets the play call from the sideline. They hit the mini huddle quickly and then hit the line. 4:12, 4:10 to go in the third. Trumley takes the handoff, roll out, complete, touchdown, Kettle Run. It's Mahaffey. What a great job by Peyton Mahaffey, the senior, at the back end of that touchdown drive for the Cougars. And they make it 45-19 with 4 minutes and 3 seconds left here in period number 3. So it's a 2-yard pass. And now on for the point after try is Curry. Trying to make it 45-20. The kick is up and the kick is good. 45-20, Dinwiddie, 4:03 left third period. We're back in 60 seconds on State Championship Saturday. Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West offers quality cleaning services for your HVAC units and can make sure your system's ready for the cold winter nights to come. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. The friendly staff at Massey Wood & West always looks out for your well-being and is working under all CDC guidelines. Need a new duct system? Massey Wood & West can handle that too. Plus, Massey Wood & West is proud to offer Rheem water heaters. So call 355-1721. Ask for Doug or Al. They'll be glad to help you get ready. 355-1721, Massey Wood & West. Online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Here comes the ensuing kickoff from Kettle Run. It'll be taken by Dinwiddie at the 3-yard line. To the 10, 15, 20, up the middle, 25. Drum Gould skips a tackle near the 30 and finally will be brought down there. Tackle made by Jack Petchen. And Dinwiddie takes over at their own 30, leading 45-20. With 3 minutes and 53 seconds left here in the third period of the Class 4 State High School Football Championship. As we bring our 20th anniversary season of high school football Friday night to a close on this beautiful Saturday evening. I know it's overcast, but it's just a lovely night here in Lynchburg. On first down, Dalton to Tucker gets hit behind the line of scrimmage. He might get a yard, and that'll be all. To the 31. Now, if I'm Dinwiddie, I don't go into conservative mode. I keep playing Dinwiddie football. It's what got me the 25-point lead. So 2nd down and 9 at the 31. Clock at 3:30 and counting, third period. If Dinwiddie is able to get the victory this evening, Rachel Witham is down on the field, and she's going to get photos of the post game as well as video of the championship trophy presentation as Tucker will take the handoff off left tackle and get to the 37-yard line for a gain of 6 to make it 3rd down and 3 at the 37. And, of course, we'll post those pictures and videos on Twitter at the RVA Sportsnet as soon as possible. Third down and three. Dalton's going to keep it himself. Jumbo read option. He's got it. First down and more to midfield. 45, 40, 35, and he'll just go out of bounds. Good idea by Harry. You're up 25. There's no reason to absorb a hit there. You know, people used to ask, I think it was Franco Harris who was quoted one time as saying, you know, people were like, well, why do you go out of bounds? Why don't you just, it's like, that's less hits and it extends my career. And he could not be more truthful. In a sport where machismo seems to matter more than anything, it really shouldn't. You need to know what battles to pick and when to save your body for another opportunity. And Dalton does just that. They restart the clock after the chain has been moved. First and 10 at the Kettle Run 34. Dalton wants it all. Looking for Drumgoole, and it's incomplete. A little bit underthrown. Christian was at the 5, and the ball fell down at about the 7. And it'll be second down. Looks like Freedom of Woodbridge is going to take the Class 6 state championship. Riverheads won the Class 1 title earlier today. And on this field, Phoebus with a huge win to capture the Class 3 title. Second down and 10 at the Kettle Run 34. 2:20 to go in the third. Here's Tucker going around left side. Gets to the 30. Holds onto that football. You know they're trying to strip it away. Down to the 25. He might have gotten an extra yard to the 24. And if he does, that'll be enough for a Dinwiddie first down. With 2:09 to go in the third. And it is first down. Generals. And there, frankly, is a situation to where, yeah, you need to get the football back. Sure, you want to try to strip him, but at some point, just tackle the guy. So first and 10 at the 24, and Harry's going to keep it again on the jumbo package right side and pick up a few. It'll be 2 to the 22 as we go under 150 to go in the third period. Well, I'm already thinking about 2023 in the back of my mind. All the changes, Highland Springs moving up to Class 6 next year. Louisa coming into 5C along with Patrick Henry Roanoke and Albemarle and William Fleming in Franklin County. Second and 8 at the 22. Here's Tucker. Gets caught from behind and then just drags a Cougar defender all the way down to the 17. He should have been stopped for 1. He gets 5 to make it 3rd down and 3 with 1:10 to go in the third period. And, of course, Class 4 next year is going to be crazy. Metolica leads it, but you still got Dinwiddie, still got Verina, you still got King George, you got Patrick Henry, you've got Hanover back, although they're going to lose a couple of critical seniors. I think Goochland will bounce back in Class 3. Caroline showing strength in 2022. King William back in Class 2. TJ 2. Dalton on the read option keeps it himself, weaving and winding his way up the middle, and he'll get inside the 10 and finally down to the 5-yard line. First and goal, Dinwiddie, with 36 seconds left here in period number 3. And the Generals on the doorstep 50 points. Final 30 seconds of the third. They have to get a play call off by 7 seconds left in the period. Dalton looking, cuts up the middle, and gets to the 2. And that will end period number 3. Dinwiddie is 12 minutes away from their first state championship in 9 years. We go to the 4th. Generals 45 and Kettle Run 20. We're back in 60 seconds here on Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721, Massey Wood & West, online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Dinwiddie will now head to the other side of the field, to the 2-yard line. Second and goal from the 2. We start the fourth quarter of the Class 4 State Football Championship. Here comes Tucker. Looking for the goal line. He's got it. Touchdown, Dinwiddie Generals. The third rushing touchdown of the night. It is 51, Tucker. 51-20 with Tucker's touchdown run. Wow. And they are celebrating across the way in Navy Nation as Van Meter's extra point is up and good. 5 seconds into period 4. It is 52-20, Dinwiddie. We're back in 30 seconds. High School Football Friday Night, State Championship Saturday edition here on Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721, Massey Wood & West, online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's Massey Wood & West.
.com 11 minutes and 55 seconds left in Lynchburg, and Raphael Tucker's third touchdown run of the day has given Dinwiddie matching their biggest lead at 32 points. It is 52-20. Ensuing kick taken by Kettle Run. They'll flip it at the 20. Look, reverse here and down to the 30, which is about where they've started all afternoon. So it'll be first down. John Slaughter, glad you're listening this evening. He notes a couple of other changes that are going to make 2023 big and different with Phoebus, who won the Class 3 title here earlier today, moving up to 4. Can you imagine a Dinwiddie Phoebus state championship game? Holy cow. First 10, Kettle Run at the 30 in desperation mode. Chumley throwing complete. First down to the 40. Bring the tackle to the 44. That'll be a gain of 14. First down and 10. Kettle Run got to be in the hurry up now. Stop the clock to move the chain. And they'll restart it now with 11:37 and counting in regularly. Dinwiddie on the precipice of their first state championship in 9 years. Chumley looking back. Going down the field, and it is intercepted. Christian Drumgool with the interception, and he brings it back to the 45, now reverses field, gets to midfield, breaks the tackle to the 40, to the 35, and finally brought down at the 28-yard line of Kettle Run. What an unbelievable play by Drumgool with the interception. The unbelievable return. And I believe Navy Nation on the other side of the field here at Williams Stadium can begin to celebrate with a 32-point lead deep in Kettle Run territory with 11:04 left. Highland Springs made it 1-0 for the 8:04. Dinwiddie right on the verge of making it 2-0 on the state championship Saturday. What a run by Christian Drumgool. And what a game for him as well. First down, Dalton looking to throw. Got a man wide open at the 10. He'll walk in again. Touchdown, Zaylin Wiggins. Touchdown, Dinwiddie Generals of 28 yards. The second time tonight that the defensive secondary of Kettle Run has completely lost a wide receiver. And Dalton, play pitch and catch as if it were Sunday afternoon in the park. And it is 58-20. 10:57 to go. This is a dominant statement by Dinwiddie. The point after try is up, and this one is no good. It'll be off to the right. 10:57 remaining. 58-20. Dinwiddie. We're back in 60 seconds on State Championship Saturday. Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721. Massey Wood & West. Online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Kettle Run fakes the reverse on this kickoff return, and they are able to get out across the 30 to the 35-yard line, where they are wrestled out of bounds over on the Dinwiddie side of the field. Navy Nation with the Dinwiddie High School marching band and the cheerleaders leading the cheers and the celebration. They can feel it and they can taste it. First and 10, Kettle Run at their own 35, but down 58-20 with 10:30 to go. Oh, and tons of movement everywhere. This might be one of those calls where the official says, false start, everybody back center. There was massive movement on the offensive line, so it'll be 15 at the 30-yard line. We talked on the pregame show earlier tonight about whether getting to this stage would be a disadvantage for Kettle Run because it was their first time ever on this stage. And even though these Dinwiddie Generals haven't been on the stage either, this program has, and this program is programmed to think they will be every year. Tap Scott in motion on first and 15. Chumley going to keep it himself up the middle, and we'll get the 5 penalty yards back to the 35-yard line. You know, it's one thing if you're part of a program that has a rich tradition, a coach who has been and won the state title. It's another if you're a team that's reaching this level for the first time ever. And I think the experience factor has certainly played itself out here tonight. So second and 10 after 5-yard gain to get the penalty yardage back. We're under 10 minutes to play. Chumley, plenty of time. Now brings the ball down. We get a penalty marker thrown. He'll go and he'll be down at the line of scrimmage. And we stop the clock with 9:38 to go to get the penalty call. And it looks like it might be a hold against the Cougars. While we have a minute, it can be a very, 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 very short pregame show. Postgame show here tonight. And I want to thank our sponsors again, Virginia Family Dentistry, the team approached the 16 Richmond area locations, vadentist.com. And when you go there and you make that first appointment for whatever the case may be, please thank them for sponsoring high school football coverage here on Rejoice and on the RVA Sports Network. And also to our friends at Massey Wood & West, fueling Virginia since 1923, HVAC units, heating oil, propane, tankless water heaters, standby generators, and so much more. MasseyWoodAndWest.com and also 804-355-1721. Officials are still sorting out this penalty marker, which is why it's taking a while to get this play call finished and going to be holding against Kettle Run, as we figure. So they'll put the football back to the 23. And it'll be second down and 22. 9:35 remaining. Chumley to throw. Looking. pass complete, and then his the receiver runs into an offensive lineman and falls down to the turf. Pass complete to Colton Quaker. But it'll be to the 21. They're actually going to lose a yard to make it third and 23 with just under 9:10 to play. Third down, Chumley to throw. Going long and overthrows his intended receiver who was in double coverage, Tapscott, by about 10 yards. And fourth down this deep in their territory, they have no choice but punt. Well, the high school football season concludes for the VHSL this evening, but there is one more game in town. Don't forget, the Big River Rivalry All-Stars senior football game returns to Randolph and College next Saturday at 12 noon. Go to Big River Rivalry on Twitter, Big River Rivalry, to get ticket information. That game will kick at 12 o'clock. Bad snap for the punter, and he has to fall on the football back at the 5-yard line. And Dinwiddie will have it first and goal. Wasn't a thing the punter could do. It was a lazy snap, and it was too high. And by the time he was able to turn around and collect it, he had to go down. So first and goal, Dinwiddie. I mentioned earlier, they scored 63 points twice. Tucker took one. Tucker looking for his fourth touchdown of the night. 50 remaining in the state championship. So Tucker to the one. Second and goal off the bad snap on the punt from Kettle Run. Here comes Felton and company. Gary takes the snap, and he's in. Make it 64. Touchdown, Dinwiddie Generals with 7:23 remaining. They've scored more points tonight than they have all season long. What a statement. What a statement tonight. So here comes the Van Meter point after try. It's up, and it's good. 65-20, there it goes on the clock. 65-20 on the scoreboard, 7 minutes and 23 seconds left. Statement made. Now it's just a matter of the final 7:23 coming off the clock. Remaining. 65-20. Dinwiddie scored 63 points this regular season. Short kick will be taken to the 30-yard line, and the Cougars will return it to about the 36. Kettle Run should not in any way, shape, or form be ashamed of their performance tonight. They have fought and clawed and battled all evening, but they simply have been overwhelmed by a more athletic team. It's as simple as that. Kettle Run will be back. And this program has made this year. I know it's going to be a hard trip back to Fauquier County tonight, but they have to keep this in perspective as to what they have accomplished in what would be a 14-1 season. Chumley rolling, looking to throw and incomplete, trying to find a dare, but he was in double coverage at the 45-yard line. 6:55 to go, and the clock will run on the 35-point. second down. And obviously, no longer in hurry-up mode. You're not going to score 46 points in 6.5 minutes. But you want to finish strong. Second and 10, 35. Shumley looking, avoids one man. Downfield, got a man. And it is caught by Rogers, complete into Dinwiddie territory to the 43-yard line. And boy, give credit to Chumley for extending that play. He had good time in the pocket, then it collapsed. He rolled right, had a man almost bring him down, shook him off, and then was able to look downfield and realize Rogers was available. At the Dinwiddie 43, gain of 22, first down, 5:50 to go. And again, coming up later this evening, we will have the trophy presentation video up on Twitter at the RVA Sports Net. Penalty marker thrown, and we're going to get a delay of game call against Kettle Run with 5:36 remaining. This will erase the heartache that I am sure is somewhere in the back. From how close they came to winning the title at William & Mary in 2016, they fell 10 yards short on a pass on the final play of the game, falling to Salem. They missed the COVID season. They were the one seed in the region last year as Chumley throws over the middle, complete slant pattern to the 33-yard line. That'll be close to first down yardage and will be a first down with 5:14 to go. Last year, they were the ones in the rugged region 4B, but stunned in the second round at home by Patrick Henry. And they came back determined this year to make a statement, and they've made their biggest one on the biggest stage here tonight. 5 minutes to play. Chumley to throw. Looks left, looks right, flushed out of the pocket, pumps, throws, incomplete. Adair, the closest receiver, covered by both Howard Spencer and Alex Elmore. 4:35 to go. We're in a running clock in the fourth quarter, with it being a 45-point advantage. At the 33 of Dinwiddie, it is second down and 10. 4:15 to go. Chumley over the middle, throws behind his intended receiver. Incomplete. He was looking for his favorite receiver, Jordan Tapscott. So third down, under 4 minutes to play. Kettle Run taking their time. From the 33, jump throw. Pick up the blitz, pass complete. Adair open inside the 25, the 20, and down to the 15-yard line. It'll be first down, Kettle Run in the red zone with 3:24 to go. So Kettle Run trying to get some points on the board to just kind of leave the field on a positive. It's going to hurt. I know it's going to hurt. But their accomplishments this season and their ability to beat teams like Loudoun County and EC Glass to make it here to state championship Saturday speaks volumes for the quality of this team. First down, Chumley tucks it to Run. It's away from one man and gets to the 11, maybe the 10. They'll give him the 10. As we go under 2:40 to play. And the most points that Dinwiddie has scored all season long, right now, 65-20. Second down from the 10. Chumley rolls right, looking to throw, and incomplete. Coming in on the surge is Savon McDowell. And forced that pass long before Chumley wanted to finish the rollout and find the open receiver. So a 15-0 season for Highland Springs, a 15-0 season in just a few moments for Dinwiddie. And the 804 will go 2-for-2 today. Third and 5 from the 10. Low snap. Chumbly hands it. Looking. Now forced out of the pocket. Cuts up the middle. Trying to get at least first down yardage, and he'll be short at the 6. As we go under a minute, 30 to go. Again, brief post-game show coming up in a moment. And we will put a cap on this 2022 high school football season, our 20th anniversary season. And what bigger way to cap it off but with a state championship win in the 804. Fourth and 1, Kettle Run at the Dinwiddie 6, final minute of the Class 4 state championship. Timeout, Kettle Run. We knew there would be a new Class 4 state champion this year when Verina lost in the region semifinals at King George. That was her last broadcast 3 weeks ago. And, of course, 2 weeks ago, we were up in Pennsylvania with Randolph-Macon College football in their second-round NCAA tournament game and how close they came from hitting the national quarterfinals. And with the way that tournament has meted itself out here in the last two Saturdays, it tells you just how close Randolph-Macon is to become an elite program nationally in Division III. Cannot wait for 2023. Also cannot wait for high school football next year as well. With all the changes and the classifications and whatnot, new rivalries, new opportunities, going to be awesome. We're so glad you've been with us all season long. Here it is, fourth down. They need a yard for a first and goal. Under 50 seconds to go. Pitch, and no. The Generals stop it, and the Generals will win. 42 seconds left. Dinwiddie will need to come out and take a knee. And that will do it. Parham led the defensive charge at the line of scrimmage to ensure this game would come to a close. Final 42 seconds. 65-20, Dinwiddie. They will put the football. I believe there might have been a dead ball foul against Kettle Run, and there was a little frustration there. So they'll put the football to the 21-yard line. And all they got to do is take a knee. Dalton goes under center for the first time tonight. It is victory formation for the Dinwiddie Generals. We're just waiting for the officials to say start, and they back up out of the way. Dalton takes a knee. And you see Navy Nation, man, across the way. So happy at what they have witnessed here this afternoon. A dominant performance by the Generals. And they do not have to take another snap. It is over. For the first time since 2013, the Dinwiddie Generals reached the top of the mountain in Lynchburg. Generals 65, Kettle Run 20, Dinwiddie your 2022 Class 4 state champions. Congratulations to Dinwiddie, and what a dominant performance this afternoon. They led at the half 38-13. Second half, they outscore Kettle Run 27-7. And they pick up just a huge win. Not a state championship, but a state championship going away. 65-20, our final score this evening as the two teams now come together at midfield for the traditional handshake, and well done by both. They both enter today at 14-0. Kettle Run had never been in this position before. But now they know what it's like to be on this stage, and you know it is going to, for the returning players next year, just feed them in the weight room in the off season, feed them in 7-on-7s, and feed them next year when they get into practice in July and August to make a trip right back here in 2023. And for getting big wins over their rival Falk here, over EC Glass, again, that state semifinal, so impressed with that victory. And I thought, you know what? If Kettle Run can beat EC Glass, Dinwiddie could have their hands full here today. But on our pregame show, we talked about a couple of things that had to happen. Dinwiddie needed to force Kettle Run to play their game. Dinwiddie did that. Check. Dinwiddie needed to not turn over the football. Check. Dinwiddie had no turnovers. Zero this afternoon. Not even a situation where they fumbled the ball and got the football back. They held on to that football like it was 60 pounds of gold, and it has led them to the promised land. And at the foot of the mountains here in Lynchburg, Dinwiddie gets to the top of the mountain in Class 4. Your final score this evening, Dinwiddie 60, Kettle Run 20. We're going to take a final 60-second timeout, come back and wrap things up from Williams Stadium at Liberty University. Dinwiddie makes it 2-for-2 for the 804. We've got two state champions on this Saturday, Highland Springs in Class 5 and the Generals in Class 4. Final 60-second timeout. This is State Championship Saturday on Rejoice 101.3 in the RVA Sports Network.
What does football and dentistry have in common? A solid defense, of course. At Virginia Family Dentistry, preventative dental care is the foundation of our playbook. But lifelong dental care doesn't stop there. From pediatric dentistry to orthodontics to tackling the most complex dental issues, like root canals or implants, we are here to put your mouth on the path to victory. Virginia Family Dentistry has 16 locations throughout Richmond. Visit virginiadentist.com for more information.
There's never been a more important time to make sure the air in your home is clean as well as comfortable. Massey Wood & West, serving Virginia since 1923, is ready to help. Massey Wood & West proudly offers Rheem heating and cooling systems. And if it's time to replace that HVAC unit, now is the perfect time to do so. So call 355-1721, Massey Wood & West, online at MasseyWoodAndWest.com. That's MasseyWoodAndWest.com.
Mission accomplished as we return here live to Williams Stadium on the campus of Liberty University in Lynchburg. The Dinwiddie Generals last appeared in a state championship game in 2016, falling on the last play of the game to Salem. And then they went through years where they had good football teams, but just could not get back to the state level. We get to the COVID season of 2020, early in 2021, when they cut off one round of the playoffs and only four teams made region playoff play. And Dinwiddie in 2020 wasn't one of them. They lost against their rival Thomas Dale. It cost them a playoff spot. They bounced back in 2021. They're the number one seed in Class 4 Region B. They win their opening game, but then they lose to Patrick Henry in a stunner in the regional semifinals a year ago, and the one seed went home. And you know that fueled the fire for the 2022 edition of the Dinwiddie Generals. Let me read off to you their final scores and their 15 wins. Ready? 55-3, 49-7, 55-7, 63-0, 42-0, 41-13, 42-0, 58-8, 50-12, 63-23. Those were the regular season games. Playoffs. They beat Powhatan 54-7. They beat Hanover 49-12. Their only struggle was that battle with King George for the region championship, winning in overtime 47-41. And then state semis at home last week, shutting out Warwick 28-0. And now they put on the biggest show on the biggest stage and put up more points tonight than any time this season. They had scored 63 on two occasions. Tonight, they put up 65 against a team that came in at 14-0. trophy and medal presentation going on right now. Kettle Run Cougars are receiving their medals. And again, I know it's going to be a disappointing trip back to Fauquier County, but Kettle Run fans who joined us for the broadcast tonight, you should be exceedingly, exceedingly proud of this team and what they have accomplished this season and the new standard that they have now set for the Cougars football program. They can be like Dinwiddie is now and expect to be at this stage, but you can't expect it until you make it. And they did make it here today, though it was not the finish and the ending that they wanted. For Dinwiddie, it's really a combination of vindication for the disappointment of 2021 and validation for the 2022 edition of the Generals. And with Harry Dalton coming back, Zaylin Wiggins is coming back, Raphael Tucker is coming back, McDowell is coming back, Davion Wilson is only a freshman, Kentel Garnes is a freshman and will be coming up soon. You go through that lineup, and yes, it's a big senior class and an important senior class, but Dinwiddie will have a lot to say as to whether or not they're able to defend this championship coming in 2023. Well, friends, that will wrap up our 20th anniversary season of high school football Friday night, and what a year it's been. It has taken us from Metoica to Charlotte, North Carolina. We've been to the new J.R. Tucker High School. We had battles at Hanover and Mills Godwin and Patrick Henry. We were with Highland Springs up at Colonial Forge in Stafford County on a Monday night. We were in the West End for battles with Douglas Freeman and Hermitage, Douglas Freeman and Glenn Allen. We saw Louisa put up 69 points on their rival Albemarle. We saw L.C. Byrd in their resurgent season that got them to the 5-7 region championship. And in the postseason, we saw the last second heroics of Hanover, the end of the run for Verina, and now the state championship in Class 4 to the Dinwiddie Generals. Want to thank Todd Wetmore from Liberty University, as well as Mike McCall and the gang of the Virginia High School League for helping us make this special broadcast possible this evening. A big thank you all season long to the best producer on God's green earth, Calvin Cecil, who has got through all of our high school football coverage this year and our Randolph-Macon College football coverage. And we cannot wait to be back with Calvin at the helm next August when the 2023 season begins, just a little over 8 months away. I need to give a couple of personal thanks before we wrap things up. Number one, to our sponsors, to Virginia Family Dentistry and to Massey Wood & West. Without their support all season long, this opportunity to bring you all of this incredible action doesn't happen. We are so thankful and so grateful to them for making the 2022 season, our 20th anniversary season, a reality. I have got to publicly thank my daughter, Rachel. She is 25 and a second-year kindergarten teacher, has her handful with about 17 students on a daily basis, yet Friday night in and Friday night out, no matter how she felt. Friday night, you don't hear her on the broadcast, but the broadcast doesn't happen, and the photos don't come without her. So, Rachel, love you, my dear, and thank you so much for your support. And to my wife back home for allowing me to do this again this year. Thank you, honey. Appreciate it very much. And finally, to Jim Jacobs and Rejoice Richmond again, for taking us in last year and for now two successful seasons at both the high school and the college level. We are so grateful to Jim and everybody at Radio Richmond for being our new home for high school football and Randolph-Macon College. All right, Mr. Brown's in the studio, so we're going to let go and bid you adieu from Lynchburg, Virginia. The Dinwiddie Generals, they score on 5 of their first 6 possessions, and they never look back. And for the first time in 9 years, Dinwiddie will claim the state championship in Class 4. Your final score one more time, Dinwiddie 65, Kettle Run 20 for everyone here in state championship Saturday. Rob Witham bidding you a very pleasant good night and happy holidays from Lynchburg, Virginia.
Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network. Thank you for listening to High School Football Friday Night, featuring the best in high school football action from across the RVA.
Tonight's game was presented by Virginia Family Dentistry, featuring a team approach to dental care. With 16 greater Richmond area locations, there's one near you. Virginia Family Dentistry features over 60 dentists and dental specialists. Go to virginiadentist.com for the location nearest you. And by Massey Wood & West, fueling Virginia since 1923. From HVAC systems to heating oil for the winter ahead. Call 355-1721 for the best service in Richmond.
Tonight's game is an exclusive presentation of Rejoice 101.3 and the RVA Sports Network, and solely intended for the private, non-commercial use of our audience. Any use of tonight's broadcast without the express written consent of Radio Richmond LLC and the RVA Sports Network is prohibited.
High school football Friday night returns on August the 25th, 2023.
It could save your life. A message from the CDC.
Here's your AccuWeather forecast on Rejoice 101.3. Plenty of clouds rolling in this evening with a low dip into 41. Cloudy tomorrow, high back up to 50.